Today, major pushback from the scientific community over a government report that downplays the severity of climate change. 85 veteran researchers issuing a joint rebuttal after the Energy Department painted climate change as potentially beneficial. One of the scientists comparing the report to a, quote, badly written blog post that makes a mockery of science. Joining us now is CNN chief climate correspondent Bill Weir. Bill, how significant is this?
It is significant. It is, you know, the voices trying to rally together, given a very limited public comment window by the Department of Energy. But it's really just their attempt to push back in what is an all-out war on science by the Trump administration, trying to gut the very foundations that lead to regulation of greenhouse gas pollutions from power plants, from tailpipes, and so forth. The National Climate Assessment, since for generations, has put out the best science on this. Well, the Trump administration killed that portal, took it offline, fired the scientists behind it. And then the Department of Energy put out this sort of memo written by five noted climate contrarians back in July. And then the EPA used that as an excuse to get rid of the endangerment finding, which is the legal underpinning for all these regulations. So now Andrew Dessler at Texas A&M and Bob Kopp at Rutgers and a host of dozens of others put out a point-by-point rebuttal. In less than a month, they put out a book-length 400-page rebuttal to this, and they're calling out specifically the mistakes, the almost willful errors, the cherry-picking of data. They point out some of the bullet points here. Sea level rise, they poo-poo the predictions on that, even though they're conservative and are being borne out in real time. Carbon dioxide is plant food, so it's beneficial for the planet, this report put out, without mentioning all of the agricultural costs of climate change and the accuracy of modeling right there. Andrew Dessler says really this comes down to a return to the tobacco battles. The goal here, he says, quote, is not to win the debate. They're never going to win the debate. The science of climate change is incredibly solid. All they're trying to do is muddy the waters, create this idea that there is a debate, and then the government used that to roll back regulations. President Trump famously promised oil and gas CEOs that he would roll back all regulations if they helped him get elected. And it isn't just these scientists. Just this week, the American Meteorological Society, the AMS seal that you see next to your favorite weathercasters on local news, they put out a statement saying this report from the Department of Energy fundamentally flawed, foundationally flawed, and is misleading. And all of this, ultimately, Brianna, leads us back to the question of this is the story of our age. Your health, wealth, and happiness is all tied directly to a climate imbalance that is careening wildly out of it. You see it week by week in the headlines from these weather events around the world. And the official stance now from the U.S. government is that it's not real. And so here is 85-plus scientists trying to at least hold the record straight.
Yeah, as you said, trying to create the illusion that there is this debate. That's a really interesting and important point. Bill, thank you very much for the report.